The Philippine capital of Manila is gearing up for the homecoming parade of Filipino Olympians set this afternoon. It will kick off at 3 p.m. at the Aliu Theater and will make its way to the Rizal Memorial Sports Complex. The Metropolitan Manila Development Authority has cautioned motorists to expect traffic congestion along affected roads and take alternate routes. Hundreds of MMDA personnel will also be deployed to manage traffic flow. Malacanang rolls out the red carpet for Filipino athletes who made their historic run at the Paris Olympics. The first family welcomed over a dozen Olympians to the palace as they make their highly anticipated return to Manila. Two-time Olympic gold medalist Carlos Yulo was awarded the Presidential Medal of Merit, while other athletes received a presidential citation. Yulo thanked all those who supported Filipino athletes in their historic campaign in Paris.
Maraming salamat po sa mga taong nagdasal po, nag-take ng effort, magpuyat para panoorin po yung Olympics. At masaksihan po yung mga pinagtrainingan po namin ng mga atleta ng Pilipino po. Sa lahat po ng atleta po, sobrang proud po ako na pinaglaban po natin, binigay po natin yung best natin sa lahat po. Dugot pawis yung inalay natin. Di pa nagsisimula yung competition, sobrang proud na ako sa inyo lahat. At ngayong tapos na yung competition, celebrate natin yung mga nakuha nating resulta at mas galingan pa natin sa mga susunod na mga competition.
The Philippines brought home 4 medals from Paris, 2 golds courtesy of Yulo and a bronze each from boxers Ira Villegas and Nesty Petesho. During the reception in Malacanang, the president announced all 22 athletes who represented the Philippines in the Summer Games will receive 1 million pesos each on top of their existing incentives from the government.
Pinapaganda ninyo at pinapatingkad ninyo ang pangalan ng Pilipino. At kaya naman, kami naman, nagpapasalamat sa inyong lahat. Isa rin ririklamo ko sa inyong lahat at napuyat ako ng 2 linggo akong puyat para manood ng sari-saring mga event. But yung puyat ko, worth it. Dahil talagang napakagandang panuorin kayo at makita kayo. Pero yung performance ninyo, may malaking kahulugan yan. It means a lot. May malaking kahulugan yan para sa amin dito na nanonood sa inyo na sumisigaw at nagsusuporta sa inyo. And that's why I think we should recognize not only the athletes, although they are, of course, deserving of recognition, but also all the support group over the years.
The Philippine president also vowing more support for Filipino athletes. President Marcos says he's looking to develop a formal structure that will provide assistance to athletes to help them excel in the global stage. This, as he admits, there is no official or technical support provided by the government to athletes.
Ang gusto kong tanungin sa kanila, ano pang magagawa natin para dumami kayong mga medalists? That's what I want to talk to. Hindi lang yung mga athlete, kundi yung mga coach, yung mga trainer. Ano pang kulang ninyo, yung mga magulang? Saan kayo nahirapan?
State auditors are ordered by the Philippine Congressional Panel to explain how confidential funds were spent by the Office of the Vice President of Sara Duterte. The House Appropriations Committee also wants them to report on the Education Department's use of confidential funds when it was still led by the Vice President. The panel's directive stemmed from a motion by Deputy Minority Leader Franz Castro. The Audit Commission had noted in its 2022 annual report that 125 million pesos in confidential funds were spent by the office of the vice president despite not having an appropriation for such expenses. The OVP also received 500 million pesos in confidential funds in 2023. A suspended Philippine town mayor who is suspected to be a Chinese citizen is ordered dismissed by the ombudsman for grave misconduct. Alice Goh was kicked out of the office even as she's suspended by the Elections Commission for a separate violation. Sherry Antores reports.
The Office of the Ombudsman finds strong evidence that suspended Bambantarlac Mayor Alice Goh is guilty of grave misconduct in the case earlier filed by the Department of Interior and Local Government. In a 25-page decision signed by the agency's special panel of investigators and Ombudsman Samuel Martires, the Ombudsman underlined Goh's conflict of interest when she continued to lead Baofu Land Development Incorporated as the lessor of Pogo Lands, even if she was already elected as Bambantarlac mayor. The evidence gathered during the investigation, as well as in the clarificatory hearing, likewise strengthened the conclusion that Goh not only planned and formed Pogo operations in Bambantarlac, but is also the mastermind of it all. Along with the ombudsman's ruling is the order to strip Goh of all benefits and to be perpetually disqualified from holding public office. Meanwhile, Goh's co-accused Business Permit and Licensing Office Officer Edwin Campo, Municipal Legal Officer Aden Sigwa, and the present Sangguniang Bayan members were found guilty of conduct prejudicial to the best interests of the service and were slapped a 3-month suspension by the ombudsman. Senator Risa Ontiveros quickly commended the Office of the Ombudsman. Solicitor General Bernardo Guevara says they will still pursue their co-warranto petition against Goh because she can still appeal the Ombudsman's ruling. Senator Win Gachalian, for his part, declares the Senate's eventual filing of cases against Goh.
Kaya ang Senado magpa-file na ng case against her for disobedience and perjury dahil nagsinungaling siya sa Senado. So ito ay isang kaso rin na para magbigay ng pressure sa kanya na lumitaw.
On Tuesday, Bambantarlac policemen assisted the Commission on Elections in serving its subpoena to Goh in her farm in Virgen de los Remedios in Bambantarlac. A caretaker who refused to identify himself received the subpoena. He did not answer the authorities' questions as to the whereabouts of Goh. Next stop was in Bamban Municipal Hall, with the Secretary of Acting Bamban Mayor Leonardo Anunciason receiving a copy of the subpoena for Goh. According to Alice Manaloto, they have not seen Goh for months now.
Actually, hindi na po kami tumatanggap ng mga subpoena from
for the mayor.
Tinanggap po namin para may copy lang siguro kami dito.
The COMELEC's misrepresentation complaint against Goh stemmed from the findings of its technical analysts that fingerprints of Goh found in her National Bureau of Investigation certificate were the same as that of Chinese national Goh Huaping in her alien certificate registration and the 5 voters' forms in the COMELEC. According to the COMELEC, Goh violated Section 74 of the Omnibus Election Code when she declared in government documents that she is a Filipino. Lawyer Elmo Duque, COMELEC Assistant Election Director for Region 3, says the subpoena for Goh is considered as served.
We are informing her that there is a complaint against her for material misrepresentation. Kaya napaka-importante itong proseso na ito because it is the right of every citizen to be informed of the nature and cause of the charge against him or her.
Goh's lawyer, Attorney Stephen David, has yet to issue a statement on these developments.
Considered as received, the 10-day grace period allotted for suspended Mayor Alice Goh starts Wednesday. This means that she has the right to submit her counter-affidavit, but if she will not submit it, that means that she's waiving her right to defend herself before the COMELEC. Sherry Antores, ABS-CBN News, Bambantarlac.
The Philippines considering another deal with China, this time to settle aerial encounters. Manila on Tuesday filed another diplomatic protest after the Chinese Air Force dropped flares in the path of a Philippine patrol aircraft. The National Security Council says this is part of a series of steps the Philippines will take to combat China's aggression in the West Philippine Sea.
They could probably consider entering into some form of guidelines for air military encounters. Because in 2018, the defense ministers of the ASEAN adopted in principle a multilateral set of guidelines for air military encounters or GAME. And the purpose of this is to enhance air safety in light of the projected increased military and civilian air traffic in the region. It's meant to lessen provocation on either side, preventing them from conducting in a manner that is that could be considered as a hostile act.
The Philippine Armed Forces, meanwhile, gave assurance it will not be deterred by China's actions, but it admits Filipino troops can perform better with advanced and modern equipment.
Our pilots will continue to take to the skies as they did. We remain steadfast in our mission to protect our territory, even in the face of flares of intimidation.
Our pilots have the necessary training. They follow the rules of engagements for every contingency, and we are confident in their capabilities.
While China displays its aerial might, it also continues to flex its muscles at sea. About 90 Chinese vessels were seen loitering in Philippine waters, two of which are conducting research in the resource-rich area. Let's get an update on the weather now from PAGASA forecaster Alzar Aurelio. Hi, Alzar. How's the weather looking like this afternoon in Manila?
Hello and good morning. For today, weak southwest monsoon affecting the northern and central zone, so we expect scattered rain showers and thunderstorms only in the area of Ilocos Region, Batanes, and Babuyan Islands. While here in Metro Manila and also the rest of the country, we expect generally good weather, which is partly cloudy to cloudy skies. But expect a sudden downpour, mostly in the afternoon or in the evening due to a localized thunderstorm. For the next 24 hours, today and tomorrow, we are not expecting LPA or tropical cyclone enter the Philippine area of responsibility. This is our latest update from PAGASA. I am Alzar D. Aurelio.
Thank you very much for that update, Alzar. I hope the rain won't dampen this afternoon's parade.